Hey, what's up? Welcome back to the channel. So right now I'm currently on a little bit of a road trip. You can see we've got the back of the van loaded up here. We are just about to hit the North Carolina line. Just got some gas, got another cup of coffee, and I'm about to hop back here and make myself a sandwich and keep on hammering down to the North Carolina, South Carolina line, where I'm gonna be staying tonight at a KOA, Campgrounds of America. Gonna do a one-nighter in the van, and gonna cook some chili dogs tonight on some delicious brioche rolls, and just kind of hang out. I'm using the Elk Ridge Badlands knife on this trip. I kind of really like this knife, so I figure, you know what, I'm gonna just start using it. Chip down. Barbecue chip down. Using my my Aldi refrigerator that I got. Oh, buddy, that knife is sharp though. She might not be the most expensive knife in the world, but she's sharp. I hit it with the ceramic rod after I made my last video, and she shaved the hairs right off your arm now. Like I got something leaking down in there. Oh dear. I've spilled a little milk. All right, we get this stuff put back in the fridge, get back up and saddle back up and get ready to ride again. But see it for yourself, 28.1 miles to the gallon. That ain't so bad. Hell no. So I was starting to say, I got all kinds of gear here in the back of the van, and hopefully I'll have a nice little camp out tonight, so we shall see. And 2.5 more hours, 179 more miles to go. All right, well, just got done stuffing my face with the delicious sandwich, and now we're going to get back on the road, and we are going to continue our journey. So, alrighty. All right, well, I'm gonna hop off here and keep pounding away at the miles, and gonna keep having my sipping, spilling, slipping, what is it? Slipping, the old Slip-In Food Mart coffee. That's some good coffee. All right, I'll see you guys a little bit later. Well, I'm driving right into the storm. I'm currently in North Carolina, and I'm heading down to right about the South Carolina border. Well, we're getting into some rain now, which I did know this was coming, and it's not like I could do anything about it. Guys, well, we are getting ready to up. Well, not getting ready to pull up in a few minutes, about 5 minutes. We're going to be pulling up to the campground for the night. I stopped and took myself a little break on the drive. I could have been here probably about an hour ago, but started raining really, really hard. And, you know, I'd already driven like 7 hours and was getting a little tired, so I just pulled it over for about an hour. Just chilled. Listened to my audiobook a little bit. So, oh, those flowers. Look at that. Boy, that's pretty. I don't know what those purple flowers hanging down were off of those trees. Maybe somebody can tell me, but those are really beautiful. We have stuff up my way starting to bloom. Tulips and stuff, but I don't recall ever seeing something like that. But that's what's neat when you get out and about. 7 hours from home and you see some cool stuff. So, all right, see you at the campground. Alrighty. Doesn't look like there's too many people. Get checked in. All right. Well, we're checked in. We've got our site DT4. Allegedly, it's the more private of the campsites back here. Now, when I camp, I prefer to be a little bit more rural and rugged than this. But like I said, the camping is kind of just secondary to the whole reason that I'm down here this weekend. So, I'll just, you know, I'd rather stay here at the KOA and get a hotel room. I mean, it's a whole heck of a lot cheaper. You get all the full amenities of a bathhouse, hot showers if you're so inclined, and it's a lot cheaper than a hotel room for the night. I think this cost me $56 for one night, which, you know, I mean, it's not like, you know, it's not like BLM land or somewhere like that where you can camp for free. And I'm sure that if I really, really dug around, I could have camped for free, but I didn't. I didn't do that. So, DT3. Okay, there's DT3. And over here's DT4. Hey, at least it backs up to the woods where I'll be. So, that's cool. There's my fire pit, parking. So, yeah. All right, well, this is going to be home for the night. like my handle? My handle broke off the van, so the old gigantic rubber zip tie or flex tie. So much warmer down here than what I'm used to. But I've got my rain jacket and I've got a nice fleece flannel if I need it. Fire pit for tonight. I'll be enjoying this. I haven't tried this yet, but I brought my fire ring for tonight, and I'm gonna maybe possibly use it to cook some of my dinner tonight. I'm gonna put it over the propane fire pit. See how dirty it is. I've used this a ton over like open fires, but I haven't cooked over my propane fire pit yet, so I think I might try it. I'm probably gonna grill the hot dogs on the little grill, but I'm gonna I got like baked beans and some leftover asparagus to heat up, so I'll probably do that over the fire pit and some frying pans. This is a little bit better view of the inside here of my little bench. This is actually like an antique, well, I don't know about antique, but it's pretty old. It's from like the 60s, toy chest, and it's all padded and it fits perfectly in my van, and I can sit right here and I've got enough room where I can pretty much, if I sit all the way towards the front, I can sit straight up. But in addition to that, I've got storage in here, which is great for van camping because, you know, I've got my little, cook stove in here. I've got some, my frying pans. I've got my, my homemade window coverings for when I sleep, so I can just fit all that stuff right here in the in this little box, and it's really good. So yeah, and then my duffel bag just rides really nicely right there while I'm traveling. It never fell or anything the whole trip. So as I was saying, you know, this is what's really nice about a no build is my cot's gonna go right here, and boom, that's it. I'm done. Blow up my little air mattress and just get my blankets. But I mean, it took me, I think, about 3 minutes or something to set up the awning, and that's because I haven't done it in a while, and it was kind of sticking to itself. All my gear's for the night unloaded. My food's in these coolers, and now I'm gonna set up my good Lord, I can't even think of what the damn thing's called now. Good God of mercy. What is that thing? My cot. Hello, cot. I'm gonna set up my cot and I'll be in my bed for the night, so. Hot dog. Well, guys, I guess in my haste, my pickle bag came open inside my little mini fridge, my little electric cooler, and got pickle juice on some things, but there's worse things in life that can happen. So all in all, it took me about 40 minutes to pretty much just, you know, go ahead and get everything basically the way I like it, so that when later when I'm ready to go to bed, I just gotta slap up a couple more of those little window coverings, and that's pretty much it. So except if I did this every day like some of these van lifers and stuff, I guarantee I could knock that down to 15 minutes, 20 minutes, no problem. But it's probably been 10 months since I've camped out of the van like this on a long trip. So that's how long it's been since I've done all this in the van. So I'm getting pretty hungry. It's it's only 3:30. So I'm not gonna make dinner real early because then I'll be hungry again. So I'm just gonna kind of keep grazing on some snacks. I brought all kinds of different kind of little snacks and stuff like that. I did pick up these, I forgot I was making chili chili dogs tonight. And excuse my crunching, but I was just at the gas station to top off the fuel tank and picked up some beer, have a couple cold ones tonight, you know. And I saw these chili cheese bugles. And I said, well, I never had them before. I love regular bugles. I'm gonna try these out. They're not too bad. They could have a bit of a more bold flavor, in my opinion. But, you know, they're not bad. But then I was like, oh crap, I'm having chili dogs tonight. So I guess I doubled up on the chili flavoring, but that's okay. These obviously don't taste like you're eating chili. So I had told you guys that I brought canned chili. Couldn't remember the exact name of it because I always make homemade chili, but I like having some canned goods on hand. And this is the one that I got. Texas Tailgate. Now, this is made in USA, and from what I've been told, this is a damn good canned chili. So, I didn't bring a bunch of spices or anything with me. I brought some salt and pepper. I didn't bring any onion powder, garlic powder, or anything like that. I do have some diced onion that I grabbed out of the fridge that was diced up a couple nights ago for tacos. I do have some of that. I might throw some of those onions, maybe saute them up in the frying pan a little bit, maybe throw some in the baked beans, maybe throw some in here. I don't know. But you know what? We're having damn chili dogs tonight, buddy. And then, what's next? I've got these delicious, and oh buddy, I mean these are delicious. These are my favorite rolls for hot dogs. These split top brioche, fancy brioche rolls. Oh, they are so good for hot dogs. I get those at Aldi, and I love them. Boy, bread makes everything. So I got that. And then just got some plain old pork and beans. You know, you can't really just go wrong. So a little bit later, we're gonna get everything all fired up and we're gonna cook up those chili dogs, and oh my, we're gonna eat. We are gonna eat so well. And I'm deciding, I brought my laptop with me. There's actually Wi-Fi here. So I'm trying to decide, do I wanna watch a movie later? Do I wanna start reading one of the books that I brought with me? Do I wanna keep listening to my audio book that I was listening to for the whole 7 hour drive down here? I'm not sure. Do I, you know, I'm not like in the wilderness, so it's not like I'm gonna be interrupting the wilderness, but I do like that I have these trees behind me anyway. All right, well, stay tuned, guys. You know, this just goes to show, guys, like you don't need some wild, crazy, you know, intricate build to get out and do things out of your van. Think of how much even more room I could have if I didn't have a little one at home. And I could take that seat out as well. I could build a box here with pullouts, slide outs. I could build a whole platform, and you know, if I wanted to, but I could literally go anywhere in this van in the country. I mean, granted, I can't take this off road, but I could still get do a lot of traveling in this no build setup, and it's just so comfy and cozy once you're inside there. So I just wanted to show you guys that, how much more room I could get by just moving the front seat out. And boy, if I could, if I had the option to take that seat out too, man, I could have so much room in this van. So I wanted to walk over here and show you guys this, whatever this is. If any of you know what this is, these flowers growing in these trees here. I do have an app on my phone that'll tell me exactly what it is. Maybe it's grapevine. I don't know. I honestly don't know. It's beautiful though. I've never seen this before. I also didn't grow up way down in the deep south either. So it's definitely a type of vine. I don't just don't know what kind of vine this is, but wow, that's really pretty. It's probably some sort of invasive species, I'm sure. Some environmentalists out there is probably like, ah! But no, I get that anyway. Sumac. Poison sumac growing in it though. Or is that sumac? I don't know. It's very pretty. It's very beautiful. If you know what that is, this purple little flower. I guess it's sumac. Is that? I can't tell if that's all together. I'm not touching it though, because I ain't trying to get poison sumac. As a matter of fact, the wife and I have already got a little bit of that from clearing brush around the house. So, on the walk back over, I'll let you take a look at the van and the camp. It's really not bad here. This isn't my first type of choice of camping, like, but you know what? I mean, for you van lifers out there, you people that do this, what do you mean, you people? You people that do this every day, don't sleep on these KOAs. You've got laundry, you've got showers, hot showers, you've got bathrooms, you've got camp stores. But here's the van and my camp. I don't have the propane fire going yet or anything like that, but give you guys a view of it from here. Not too shabby. Not too shabby, if I do say so meself, and I do say so meself. So, I got neighbors right across there, but that's okay. I'm still enjoying it. It's just something different. So, all right, see you later. All right, my friends, this is what we're gonna do. We got our baked beans. We got our chili sauce. We got our diced onion. There's some tomato in there too. We got our salt and pepper. We got some mustard. We got some ketchup. We got our hot dogs. All right. Over here, we've got our camp cook set up here. We got the little grill, and we've got the, I believe the name of this one is the, yes, Outland Living. We've got the Outland Living propane fire pit, which is freaking awesome, by the way. Now, I'll be quite honest with you. If I wanted to, I could squeeze these over here and I could cook the hot dogs and everything on one. I could cook everything right here over one system, unit, whatever the hell you want to call it. But I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to give myself plenty of room so my pans can heat up nice and evenly. And I'm going to throw the hot dogs on the little grill here because I've already got it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get everything prepped. I'm going to get the baked beans in a pan and get them mixed up with a little bit of flavor. Just nothing crazy. I'm going to add some ketchup, a little bit of that mustard. I'm going to add some salt and pepper and get them over there on the fire heating up. And I'm going to let the other pan heat as well. Actually, you know, I could probably just put everything in and just let it start heating up. I'm not like really salt. Actually, yeah, you know what? No, I'm going to saute some onions first. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to get the baked beans going on a low heat. Going to saute up some onions. And then those sauteed onions are either going to end up topping the chili dogs, or they're going to go into the chili sauce and the baked beans. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with them yet. I'm not sure how I'm going to incorporate the onions, but I'm going to incorporate them somehow, some way. So also I'll be able to throw my brioche hot dog rolls into the little propane grill. You know, I brought the little propane grill, so I'm going to use it. Oh, and also here I've got some leftover asparagus there that I've also got to heat up. Not 100% sure how I'm going to do that yet, because I got to heat the chili sauce up in one pan. I got to heat the baked beans up in another pan. Maybe I'll lay those asparagi over the grill, the grates on the grill. So, all right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set up the camera and just start recording as I do these things. And, yeah, man, this is going to be so good. All right. So now I'm confident enough anyway, that my pan for my onions is ready to go. Wow. Do you need that much butter, homie? Probably not. I could throw a little more olive oil in there too. That's okay. Butter, olive oil,
It's all good to me. You can see I'm still using the old knife here. All right, what do you say we start sauteing up some onions? Now, I do typically like to have this a little hotter. There's a little tomato in there, too. You know what? Screw it. Let's just do it all. Let's just saute up the tomato and the onion. We're going to live dangerously tonight. Going to have all the nightshades. Oh, yeah. Ooh, our baked beans are on a hot spot. It's okay. Oh, yeah, you hear that sizzle now. You hear those onions and those tomatoes sauteing up now. Oh, that's going to be good. That fresh tomato and that fresh onion in there with that chili, that canned chili. All right. Put my pig sticker back in its holster. Man, I hate this holster on this knife. It's the only thing I don't like about it. Holster. Oh, these hot dogs are already getting charged up, buddy. Not charred up, charged up. What's a charged up hot dog, you ask? You're looking at it. All right, guys, so I'm going to turn the camera off for a minute just because I don't want this to run like this segment to run too long. But basically, all I'm going to do is I'm just going to keep sauteing up these onions. The only thing you're not going to see is me just continuing to saute these, make sure the beans don't burn, and then I'm going to incorporate the chili, and I'll get everything kind of plated up at the end. So stand by. All right, I'm going to go ahead and turn off my propane. Oh my God, I can't even explain to you guys. I'm not going to need two of these or three of these. There's no way. I'm going to end up leaving the third one here on the grill. I mean, just look at that. Buns just a little bit charred, but not burnt brioche. Look at those hot dogs. I mean, come on. Oh, my God. Turn that off now. All right, guys. So I'm going to taste this first. I've still got some water in this. We'll just drink this. We're going to throw some mustard up on these bad boys. Oh yes, yeah, son. Get my fork. Gonna taste some of this here with you guys on camera to see how it tastes, and then I'm gonna turn the camera off, listen to my audiobook while I eat. Oh yeah. Those beans, though. Oh, yeah. Oh. That's the way to do it right there, Jack. That asparagus, cooked from the night before and then heated back up over the grill. It's got that smokiness. All right, here we go. I mean, look at that. I'm gonna, oh my God, that's the best chili dog I may have ever had in my life. I'm not even kidding. I'm gonna need some time alone with this, you guys. Oh my God. There's so many flavors coming together here. You've got the brioche roll with being crisp on the grill. You've got the sauteed onion and tomato, which I didn't even plan on incorporating the tomato. It's just I already had that cut up at the house from tacos a few nights ago. Sauteed that up with olive oil and butter. The chili. Oh my God, the canned chili, which is delicious on this hot dog, as advertised. The mustard, the just plain French's classic yellow. No fan, not that I love fancy mustard, don't get me wrong, but You've got the butterness, butteriness of the roll. Oh my God, it's just all coming together. Well, got it on my pants. Oh boy. I might have that third hot dog. I've already inhaled those two. And I think I may go back for thirds. Question is, do I need to? I don't think anybody needs three hot dogs, but it might just be a three hot dog kind of night because holy crap. There's always something about when you're out. Now, I know this is really camping, but just when you're outdoors and the food is just always so much better. I don't know what it is, but oh my God. I feel like it's a sin. All right, let me get another hot dog. I gotta tell you, the sauteed onions and mushrooms. I'm not trying to beat a dead horse, but that just added something to it that just wouldn't have been there otherwise. Well, I'm beyond satisfied with tonight's meal. So simple, so delicious, not healthy. Good old hot dogs, brain food, canned chili, canned baked beans. Best thing was probably the asparagus. And, but not every day can be rainbow farting unicorns. Sometimes you just eat like this. So, all right, I'll be back. Well, I just gorged myself. And that was delicious. And now I've got to do everybody's least favorite part of everybody's least favorite part of camping, which is cleanup. But honestly, it's going to be a pretty simple cleanup. I'll just throw this away. I might even save this plastic fork. Well, all right, guys, I'm gonna start winding her down for the night. Got all cleaned up from dinner. It was really delicious. Got the propane fire pit going now. I tell you, these propane fire pits are, you know, gonna really probably nice. Begin to wind her down for tonight. You know, after this, I'm just gonna crawl inside the van and probably go to sleep. I've been up since 2:30 in the morning. I had a seven, eight-ish hour drive. There's a lot of heavy rain. So I'm looking forward to crawling inside the van. What that noise was. Anyway, looking forward to crawling inside the van and laying down. And I think been listening to my audiobook for like 7 hours. I watched a little bit of YouTube there when I was eating dinner. Still haven't decided yet what I'm going to do. I'm either going to try and find some sort of zombie apocalypse movie possibly or something like that for tonight, or just keep listening to my book, which is kind of like that. I'm not sure. Even though I've been listening to it for like 8 hours, I'm still not sure what exactly the full plot is. It's like government conspiracy and secret islands and some sort of scientific experiments and some sort of cross mutations with humans and all sorts of tomfoolery going on in that book. But I'm still not 100% sure what the adversary that the protagonist is going to be going against. I don't know yet, so we'll see. We'll find out. But it's so far, it seems like the book is by Dean Koontz, and it's called The House at the End of the World. And it's pretty good so far. I'm listening to an audio version, and it's pretty entertaining. I enjoy it so far. It's not post-apocalypse, but it's like pre-apocalypse, I think. And maybe they're going to try to stop the apocalypse. And there's these like, you know, this group of this like archipelagos where these island chain where people are living, and there's this one island that no one lives on. That's some sort of secret government facility where they're doing some sort of testings and cross mutations and, you know, splicing people's DNA. I think I haven't said that yet, but that's what I think is going on. And maybe there's some little sprinkle of the occult, then supernatural, maybe extraterrestrial. I'm not 100% sure yet, but you know, it's got a little bit of everything. It's got mystery, it's got science, it's got firearms, it's got a survival aspect, it's got like an adventure aspect. So we're gonna see how it goes. So I might keep listening to that when I decide to crawl into the van, or I might try to find a movie. But I've also brought some books along. I brought some kind of vampire book, some other book, these old books that I have like from the 80s and the 90s, like in my personal library, that I just always know someday I'm going to read them. And I start, grab one and I read them and working my way through them. So, but all right, guys, well, I'm going to wrap it up here for tonight, unless something exciting happens or there's something else I want to grab here on the footage. I'm going to sit here and polish off this last adult beverage and enjoy this fire a little bit more, and then I'll be seeing you guys in the morning for some coffee and breakfast. So not sure what breakfast is going to be yet, but I guess we'll find out together in the morning. So all right, see you guys in the morning.
Hey, what's up, guys? So before it's morning, I did tell you guys that I was gonna show you the inside of my van once I got in here for the night and I got my lights turned on and everything like that and got all cozified. So which I just did. So that's what I'm gonna do. Right now I'm sitting on my, I know it's hard to see because it's dark in here, but I just have to take my word for it. Sitting on my little bench that I showed you guys. And you know, I can't fully sit all the way up, but I can sit up pretty good. Good enough anyway. So I'll show you the rest here. All right, so this is one of my lights that I have on, but that's the front of the van. That's where my curtains are. turn this. See. Kind of lets you see what the ambiance is like in here with just these lights on. And I'll turn that other bright light back on. Now here's my cot. And then if I'm laying on my cot, which I am right now, and it's super comfortable. This is the view. The view from below, looking above. So let's go ahead and switch that light back on. And you kind of see in here a little bit better. So I'm laying on my cot right now. There's my feet. Got all my window coverings up. Now, here's my bench. Got a book. I know it looks like some kind of chick book. It might be a chick book. I don't know. It's one of those books I was telling you about. Started reading it. It's actually pretty good so far. It's like an early 90s book. This is my solar generator, my 300 watt hour solar generator. And I have a 100 watt solar panel that I can hook up to this to keep it going. And right now I've got my cell phone hooked up to it, but I've got four USB ports there. I got 12 volt DC. It's got a flashlight. But then what's cool about it is when you turn it around, it's got another, kind of hard to see because the lighting is not so great, but you can see there it's got AC outlets as well. So, and it says right on the side, it's got all your information that you need right on the side there. 300 watts and okay, so I'm sorry, 300 watt max, 200 watt hours. So I can run a device up to 300 watts that peaks at 300 watts, which isn't bad for just a little tiny solar generator. Honestly, it's really not. That little thing is sweet. I have been using this thing for a number of years and I love it. I can run USB lights off of it. Right now my USB lights are just running off a little battery pack. But yeah, so you know, it's real simple in here. And this is it. I've got literally plenty of room. It's pretty chilly outside tonight and it's nice and toasty in here. I'm not running any kind of heater or anything like that. So, yeah, so, I mean, not running any heat in here or anything, just body heat right now. And, you know, probably, I know it's not the greatest lighting, probably not the greatest sound either. Well, the sound might be okay, but I mean, I've got plenty. I mean, you can see I've got plenty of room. I've got more room than I'll ever need to sleep in here. Oh, this cot is so comfortable too. I mean, I am so comfortable right now. And I was telling you earlier with the way that I just pushed the cot right up against that chair. I can just sit up. I don't know how well you can see me. Doesn't really matter, but I'm just comfortably lounging right now, just chilling right up against the seat of this. I could put my laptop over there, watch a movie, sit here and read a book. And what's cool about it is I've got remote control color of my lights. I can make them red, green, back to white, some weird blue color, turn them down, turn them up, turn down for what, turn up for what, I don't know. But yeah, so this is pretty much it, you guys. I could honestly, if I had to, if it was like really inclement weather, I could cook in here. I can ventilate these back windows. It's got like the kind of like little bat wing windows. You know, like I said, I can't fully sit up all the way, but I can sit up enough that you're not gonna like, you know, really get a terrible backache. And if I was gonna run this all the time, I would do away with this cot. I'd build a platform right here where this cot is, and I would drop it down. Probably about 3 or 4 inches is all, and it would be perfect. You'd be able to literally sit all the way up. It's just because I'm using this cot that's a little tiny bit tall for in here that I'm even, you know, that I'm a little bit crouched. But, you know, even with that, it's not terrible. But, all right, well, told you I'd show you the inside of the van when I got in here, and now I'm in here. So I'm a man of my word, and I will see you in the morning for coffee and breakfast. Goodbye.
Ah. Oh, good morning. Well, I slept pretty well last night. I don't know what the temperature inside the back of the van is here, but oh man, I was plenty warm. I had hoodie on. I got 2 sleeping bags. I got really, really warm at a couple points and just had to ditch the 1 sleeping bag altogether. But at some point it got a little chillier, so I grabbed it and put it back over me, but slept really well. You know how it is, you know, when you camp and stuff, usually your first night or two, the sleep is not the greatest because you're not in your regular bed at home, so your body's just, you know, somewhere different. But I got into such a deep sleep at one point that I really did think I was in my bed at home. I didn't know any different. But I usually wake up a couple times in the middle of the night when I'm sleeping at home anyway, so. Yeah, slept really great. It's about 7 a.m. right now. So, I'm gonna get some coffee going and enjoy some hot coffee. And then I'll start getting camp packed up at some point. I don't have to be in a real big rush this morning because I don't have to leave here until about 11 a.m. So I got like 4 hours to work with. Well, 3.5 hours probably by the time I get moving here. So plenty of time.
Plenty of time. All right.
I'll see you when I get some coffee.
Hey guys. I also got to heat up water for my peak meal, which doesn't take a lot. In addition to the way I'm going to make it right now, I've got these coffee bags. These Wildland coffee, single serve coffee bags. Excuse me. They're pretty much like tea bags with coffee. They're pretty good. I used these when I went out to elk hunt in October out in Colorado. They just don't get as strong as a flavor as I like with my coffee. But they're still pretty damn good. It's like one of the closest things you can get to fresh coffee up on top of the mountain, like if you're not at base camp and you're not wanting to hump around a bunch of gear. So we're gonna let this come to a boil while that's boiling. This is my French press. So this is real easy. Show you how this is done here. So just make sure everything's tight. It's got the plunger. You just push that up. Doesn't matter when you do that, but got my Cafe Maro. Now, when you make coffee like this, you don't have to let your water get all the way to a boil. You can. You don't have to. But you can. All right, so here's my coffee. I take 3 teaspoons or tablespoons myself. I like my coffee strong. They're a little over, it's fine. Right into the bottom. Two and three of those. Seal this back up. I have to dig out a Ziploc. All right, our water is where we want it now. Just starting to boil, but not quite to boiling. And all you do is you just pour this right over the grinds. Perfect amount of water. Screw this on. Make sure the plunger's up. That's the important part. That's the only really important step of this, is that the plunger is up. All right. Our water is where we want it now. Just starting to boil, but not quite to boiling. And all you do is you just pour this right over the grinds. Perfect amount of water. Screw this on. Make sure the plunger's up. That's the important part. That's the only really important step of this, is that the plunger is up.
All right.
Well, given this about 8 minutes, now all you do is you just press the plunger down, and you'll meet a good amount of resistance because it's got a really tight seal in there. And that's good, because now what you've got is you've got your, and do not drink it straight out of this thing. It will freaking burn your mouth. Oh, that coffee smells so good. Got yourself nice fresh brewed coffee with no grinds because of the filter at the bottom inside of the press. The grinds are forced all the way down at the bottom, and then it's got holes all in it that doesn't let the coffee grinds through. That's some good, strong, pretty much black coffee for the most part. Right. Our water has come to a rapid boil. I've been using that one canister for, feels like forever. This is a lot of food. This is a lot of food. Well, my peak meal is done. My God, this is so much food. I put some hot sauce and some black pepper in it. I haven't tried it yet though. Still kind of lacking flavor. It's not bad. I kind of got burnt out on freeze-dried meals. I've had so many of them out camping. All right, guys, well, that'll do it for this video. Hope you enjoyed my little camp out and my little trip. Hopefully it'll inspire you to possibly get out there as well. I know sometimes when you watch some of these overlanding and van life videos and such, it seems probably impossible for a lot of us to think that we can get out there and do things like that, but it's really not. You know, hopefully this video showed that, you know, if you've, with minimal gear, and honestly, you don't even need a van or SUV or anything like that to do this. You can have a small car and bring a tent and all the same equipment along and just sleep in your tent instead of sleeping inside your vehicle. As a matter of fact, there's people that are just right down from me. You can see them in the background of some of the footage. That's exactly what they did. They have two cars and they brought a tent and they look like they're just having a great time. They've got two dogs and they're doing it. So you can do this with any vehicle, minimal equipment, and just get out and see some different areas and have fun. So all right, well, I'm gonna continue my trip here, grab my daughter, and start driving the long drive back north to the home base. All right, well, I appreciate you guys being here. If you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel, thumbs up, all them things, share the videos, whatever. And I'll see you on the happy hunting grounds. Thank you.